With so much content whizzing around out there, there's only one storytelling platform that helps you keep calm and stay informed and inspired. Flipboard. Flipboard curates the world's stories so you can be smarter in your work, life, and play. Choose from thousands of topics to personalize Flipboard and get the latest stories from the best publishers and experts delivered to you 24/7. When you see stories you want to save or share, tap the plus button to add them to private or public collections. It's that simple. Used by millions of people every day, Flipboard is how people move themselves and the world forward. Get started now at Flipboard.com.
It's the E-Commerce Minute, your daily dose of e-commerce, tech, and retail news with your hosts, Bart Meraz and John Suter. The E-Commerce Minute is a production of Sumo Heavy, a digital commerce consulting firm in Brooklyn, New York, and Philadelphia. Find us on the web at sumoheavy.com.
It's E-Commerce Minute, episode 236.
In today's episode, Amazon Sears tire partnership. A little too late.
Sears has entered into a partnership with Amazon to sell and install tires, both DieHard branded and others, at Sears Auto Centers nationwide. The deal marks the debut of Sears DieHard tires on Amazon. Customers can shop for tires on Amazon, then use the ship-to-store function built in Amazon's checkout. After selecting their tires, the function allows the customers to choose one of the local Sears Auto Center locations and their preferred date and time for installation. A standard installation fee will be applied. The order center will then follow up and confirm the date and time of the appointment. Sears DieHard products began appearing on Amazon in December. The product selection was expanded in February to include automotive batteries. Tires will be rolled out in coming months along with the installation option. The tire partnership with Amazon is a continuation of Sears' transformation strategy, which CEO Eddie Lampert says is an ongoing process and we are not done. The partnership is an extension of the one started in July 2017 when Sears began selling Kenmore appliances on Amazon and connected its smart appliances to the Alexa voice assistant platform. Sears said it would also launch a new line of Kenmore smart appliances on Amazon and through Alexa, further expanding its relationship with the e-commerce giant. Sears has a rough road ahead to stay alive in the transforming retail sector. Sears posted a much-needed fourth-quarter profit this February, but it's still on the death watch as one of the 12 retailers at risk of bankruptcy in 2018. Partnerships with e-commerce companies like Amazon may help stem the losses, but many think it's merely prolonging the iconic chain's demise.
So you mean it's going to be Amazon Auto Centers?
Well, let's talk about that. This is great for Amazon because what do they get out of this?
They get to service, right? Like they get, you know, they don't have to ship it somewhere out or like to people. They just ship it to the store and done and done. I mean, imagine doing the Prime on, and in 2 hours, you have your tires and they're installed.
Well, if they're not even shipping it, the tires are already at the Sears place. So that's right. That's easy for Amazon. And it's great for Sears because what that does is that's just another sales channel for them. And the other thing that Sears benefits in that it brings what much needed foot traffic to the stores, although a lot of the Sears Auto Centers are kind of like a pad site off, like kind of next to the Sears. They're not exactly in the Sears, but the hope is, hey, you're coming to Sears to get your tires done. Why don't you come in and buy a screwdriver or a shirt?
Yeah, that's not going to happen. I think it's going to be, they're just going to convert all of them into Sears auto places, and that's about it. They'll do that stuff because it just makes no, you know what I mean? Like they'll do quick changes and or oil changes and stuff like that.
Amazon's also trying to push aggressive private brand strategy. When you look at all the private brands that Sears has, the Kenmore, DieHard, Craftsman that they sold off, you know, they can learn all that. They can experiment within a, you know, they can use Sears to experiment because Sears is the wounded animal here. So they could probably dictate what they want to do.
Yeah. I mean, it's just sad. Like watching Sears just being literally picked apart. You know, they're selling off everything possible. I don't think they're going to come back. So
if you look 15 years ago, when you think of the Kenmore, Craftsman, Die Hard, they were brands on their own and they were created by Sears.
Yep.
Those brands were worth more. They're worth more than what Sears and its entire Sears and Kmart together are worth now, which is just mind boggling. If you look back at Sears, Sears was the original Amazon. Sears was, you would get a Sears catalog, and the Sears catalog, I don't know if you remember Sears catalogs.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But they were like 2 inches thick, and it had literally everything in there. I mean, it was everything. The Amazon of the day. And somewhere along the line, now, obviously, retail transformation, in air quotes, has a lot to blame for this. E-commerce, certainly. but they really stumbled. They didn't make a lot of moves that they should have. And it's the typical, like, they're too big for their own self. And once they turned around and realized that they'd stumbled, it was really too late because they're just so big. And now with Sears, the reason that Sears still exists is because of the massive amounts of real estate that they still own.
Yeah.
And so Sears is not, don't even look at the brands anymore. It's a real estate play. And it's really sad.
Bad real estate play now.
So the CEO Lampert, I read some things about him. He's not really looked upon as like the savior of Sears. He's just kind of there. And I think moves like this will bring a little money into Sears. But the problem is malls are dying. We've seen it. I'm actually kind of shocked that Sears is still
ticking.
I purposely visited a Sears in a mall near me that I'd gone to years and years ago. And I was there the week before it closed. And it was just such a sad place to be in. Besides price, I just can't imagine why people would want to shop in a place like that. There's another Sears up, and I know where you know this is, up in Chamonix Mall. That's been there since, and that's kind of like an iconic Sears around here. Still holding on. That one isn't so bad. But still, if you're given choices between your time and your money and all that, blah, 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 you're not going to go there. You're not going to go there and buy clothes. It's pretty sad. So I think what we'll see after this is they're just going to start picking the bones clean of Sears, and Sears will transform into, like you had said, the auto centers. I don't know any numbers on them. I don't know if they're profitable. I don't know if they're, you know, but maybe they'll spin off into something else.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's if you look at it, that's always needed, right? Like, you can't send your car out in the box and then getting shipped back in a box.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. You still got to get your car fixed. Right. You know, it's like people still have to eat. So Amazon had to buy grocery stores, you know?
Well, I mean, that's true, right? So then all of a sudden you have the auto part stuff, and that might work for them too, right? They're going to go against AutoZone and Pep Boys and see what happens.
That's a good point. I actually didn't even think of that, because they could compete in that area because they have, you know, again, we talked about the experimentation they're doing with Sears. Plus, Amazon is a master of what? They're a master of data and logistics. And if they decided to move into that category, they could probably wipe Pep Boys off the face of the earth.
Right. But also, you got to look at the other behemoth has auto stuff, right? Walmart has it. So
good point. Yeah. I mean, you have Walmart and you have Sam's Club. I know a lot of people that just go to Sam's Club for their tires. They get the cheap tires there. So,
and you get them installed, because a lot of them now have, you know, auto stuff. So Amazon has to play that game a little bit and see where they're going to fit in. And it's not a bad way to do it.
Good point. Yeah. So I guess what we'll have to keep an eye on is not only through Sears, but to take a look at the moves that they're going to make in the next 6 months in the automotive space. Cause that's not something that we've really talked a lot about. We talk about drugs, we talk about grocery, but we don't really talk about automotive. So I have to keep an eye on this. Got anything else?
Nope.
All right. That's your e-commerce minute for today. We'll see you on the internet tomorrow. That's it for today's show. If you like the show, do us a favor and subscribe, or leave us a review on iTunes. And don't forget, you can now listen to the e-commerce minute on your Amazon device. Just add e-commerce minute to your flash briefing. And finally, if you have a comment or suggestion, or just want to say hi, find us on social media at Sumo Heavy.